If you're going to understand Crohn's disease, you need to understand where it hits, and that would be your digestive tract. So let's get started. Your digestive tract is also known as your gastrointestinal tract, or GI tract for short. It's a long and connected series of tubular organs that manage the food you eat. These organs are joined by valves called sphincters that open and close as necessary, like little doors. The GI tract begins at your mouth and ends at, well, your rear end. To illustrate how it works, let's consider what your body does to a delicious slice of cheese pizza after you eat it. First you chew it, hopefully well, and swallow. And then you forget about that bite as you take another. But your GI tract doesn't forget. It's just getting started on that pizza. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's get back to your mouth. As you're chewing, the salivary glands in your mouth release saliva to help moisten the chewed up food and to begin digesting it. When you swallow, your tongue helps flip the mouthful into your throat, which moves the food quickly down through your esophagus and into your stomach, using a muscle movement called peristalsis. In fact, your GI tract uses peristalsis to move food along its entire length and then out of your body. The pizza then enters your stomach, where it meets some pretty serious acid and digestive juices that will begin to break it down to allow your body to take whatever nutrients it can from the cheesy mess you're enjoying. Think of your stomach as working like a washing machine, except replace the soap with acid and digestive juices. Your stomach will squeeze and relax to mix the pizza with its digestive juices and slowly turn the pizza into a chunky soup. When this process is complete, the food is then pushed into your small intestine where the nutrients can be absorbed. Now the pizza is in your duodenum, the uppermost area of your intestines. It's the beginning of a series of remarkable organs that are about 8 meters or 26 feet long and are folded over on themselves to fit inside your abdominal cavity. Think garden hose. But unlike a hose, the lining of the small intestine is wrinkled and bumpy to increase its surface area and its ability to absorb nutrients. There are lots of blood vessels connected to your intestines which carry the absorbed nutrients to your liver. The intestinal wall also adds mucus, which acts as a lubricant for the food mixture, and water, which helps to dissolve the stuff that's getting digested. So we're all on the same page. When we refer to digestion, we're referring to the process of breaking down the food to allow our body to absorb its nutrients. Other things called enzymes are released into your intestines from other organs, like the liver and pancreas, to help digest proteins, sugar, and fats in the food. The pizza will have most of the nutrients removed from it in your small intestine, and your intestinal contents will become more liquid as they make their way through the jejunum, which is the middle of your small intestine, to the ileum, the lower part. All but about 1 liter of fluid will be absorbed before it empties into your large intestine. The small and large intestine meet at a place called the cecum. The ileum and cecum are the most common areas affected by Crohn's disease, but we'll get into those details later. A confusing problem when trying to learn the various parts of your body is that different people refer to the same organs with different names. To be clear about these names, the large intestine, the large bowel, and the colon all refer to the same organ. Now back to the journey. Your large intestine adds mucus to your intestinal contents, now called stool. Absorbing water is the major role for the large intestine. In fact, by the time your stool reaches the end of your large intestine, called the rectum, it is normally quite solid. What's left of your pizza will be further digested by the many bacteria that live in your large intestine, which does tend to create gas. So stop blaming the dog. You can blame it on the real culprits, your intestinal bacteria. But these little guys also make some good things happen, like producing vitamin K, which helps your blood to clot. The bacteria are necessary to the healthy functioning of our intestines, so don't think of them as bad or gross. In the end, that's where we're at now. Your pizza is transformed into stool, which leaves your body through your anus. Yes, you may refer to it by other names, including poop at this point, but that's the story of what your GI tract does to the food you eat. Now go have a healthy snack and get your amazing digestive system working for you. So, where to next?